This place is literally crawling with rats. Thousands of them scampering around, and no one can kick the little creatures out.
I am petrified by rats.
Frightened or not, these people aren't running from the vermin. They're praying to them.
Amazing that they're worshiping the rats.
But worshippers are in search of something even more spiritual. They travel here from around the world hoping to see, or better yet, touch, one of the four white rats that live here.
It's very auspicious to if you could see a white rat. That's what we believe.
Welcome to the Bhagwati Karniji Temple in Rajasthan, India.
It's just a different form of worshipping something else. We all worship different objects all around the world, and the rat should be just as important an object as anything else.
In this ancient Hindu shrine, rats are considered sacred. They're believed to be the incarnated descendants of a Hindu deity.
Human beings who die are reincarnated as rats, and rats who died are reincarnated as human beings.
600 years ago, the goddess Karniji and her four sons worshipped in this marble sanctuary, which was free of rats at the time. Her sons would take turns taking care of the shrine for 30 days at a time. Even today, her male descendants continue the tradition. They serve as priests and must spend a month tending to their reincarnated relatives called Kabas, the children of the goddess.
Imagine 30 nights of sleeping with rats. Incidents of rats biting their extremities are not unknown.
The rats never have to forage for food. Instead, they're fed a steady diet of sweets, grain, and milk by their followers. And some visitors to the temple actually eat the rats' food, convinced it will bring them good fortune. But it's the divine white rats that are believed to be the incarnations of the goddess's four sons. Devotees say that if you touch one of these sacred kabas, you're blessed for life. Amazingly, this vermin-infested shrine has reportedly never been hit by any rat-related illnesses.
The run-of-the-mill rats that you'd see at home usually are smelly and dirty. The ones over here apparently are much cleaner.
In fact, visitors are more worried about hurting the rats rather than the other way around. Blessed with such a secure life, the rats within the Bhagwati Karniji Temple apparently never want to leave.
The rats within the temple don't go out, and the rats outside the temple don't come in.
After a day at the temple, even the most petrified visitors walk away with a new respect for the rodents.
It's right there and I'm not moving, so it's like changed my attitude really.
I don't want to offend Hindus or criticize Hinduism, but we need to see the facts. In so many temples, the worship of creatures is going on. The Bible says in Romans chapter 1, they worshipped the creature and they forgot the Creator. The God who created the whole universe, this air, the human beings, He wants us to worship Him. And that God manifested in this world in the person of Jesus Christ. He lived a sinless, holy and perfect life. And Jesus shed His precious blood on the cross. You know, my friend, why did He die? He died for your sins and my sins. That is how much He loved us. And He was buried. After 3 days, He rose again from the dead. And now He is a living Savior. He loves you. And He wants you to trust Him so that you can have eternal life. So don't take it as a criticism, but it's a fact. The world is turning from true